Unit 2. A Revolutionary New Calendar. June 2nd. In the late 18th century, revolutions swept through France. The old regime of the king, the nobles, and the Catholic Church was cast aside by the people. During this era, there were sweeping changes in France's laws, one of which was the Republican calendar. The leaders of the revolution felt the traditional calendar, which was full of saints' days, was too closely connected to the church. They wanted a new version, inspired by nature and the toil of the common people. A committee was assembled, including playwright Fabre d'Églantine, who named each day and month of the new calendar. The resulting calendar was first used in 1793. It contained 12 months with new names related to nature, weather, and the seasons, such as Thermidor, heat. Each month had 30 days. The 5th, 15th, and 25th days were named after animals, while the 10th, 20th, and 30th were given the names of agricultural implements. The other days were named after plants or minerals. Today, for example, the month would be called Prairial, and the day, the 15th, Quail. Another of the calendar's innovations was to make everything decimal. A week was 10 days long, a day lasted 10 hours, each hour contained 100 minutes, and each minute 100 seconds. These radical changes were unpopular with workers, who now only got one day in 10 off work. Ultimately, the Republican calendar lasted no longer than the Republic itself. Emperor Napoleon abolished it in 1805, and France returned to its old system. These days, a few enthusiasts follow it for their own amusement, but otherwise, the Republican calendar and decimal time are nothing more than curious inventions that never quite caught on.